Okay, students, welcome again to my class, ACQR. I'm Juan Olivo with Molina High School. And this is the second day that we cover this topic of tree diagrams. I think it's needed that we review again because I saw some kids struggling with this topic, okay? So the first thing, I will explain this this diagram that is about the students from 10, 11, and 12th grade. In those students are at Molina High School, and they need to retake the STAR test. You can see I have students from 10, 11, and 12th grade. I have males and females, and the subject that they are going to take is English, math, and science. Okay. So the first thing that we need to know is the tree diagram has several branches. Okay. The first and the main branch splits into three branches. So going for any of those branches is the probability is just 1/3, okay? So this 1/3 applies for all the branches, okay? So it's for the 10th grade, it's also for the 11th grade, and it's also for the 12th grade, okay? So you can see that going for any of those branches is just 1/3. Let's continue with the next branch about the gender, male or female. As you can see, you have two. So going for any of those branches is the same probability, again, is 1/2. 1/2. Okay. And this applies for every single branch. Okay. So it's 1/2 for this. It's also 1/2 for this. It's also 1/2 for this. Okay, please remember that it's needed that you take notes, okay? You need to be taking your notes. You can access to them for the DOL, okay? And now we have the other branch that is about the, how can I say, the topic or the test itself, English, math, or science. As you can see, we have three different branches, so we are going to split this by three. Okay, and let me start here with black color. It's 1/3 for the first one. It's also 1/3 for the second and 1/3 for this one too. Okay, and it will be repeat for all the other branches. Okay, so for the next one, I have the same, the same, 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 and the same. Okay, so what can we do with those fractions, okay? So what about getting the probability for someone from 10th grade and that person is male and will have English? Okay, the first thing is only one specific person is in that category, only one, and it's right here, okay? It's only one. So we can count all the possible outcomes. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Okay, I have 18 possible outcomes. So the probability for someone from 10th grade also is male and also is going to take English is 1 out of 18. Okay. In addition to that, this is if you just solve this visually. But also, if you go to the fractions, you can also multiply. You can multiply all the fractions to get to that point. And the first fraction, as you can see, is 1/3. This times 1/2, that is the second fraction, times 1/3 again. Okay, so this is equals 1 times 1 times 1 is 1 over 3 times 2 is 6 times 3 is 18. Okay, so as you can see, this is easy. It's not difficult. And let me check something real quick. And I need to go to my to here. Okay. All right. So let's stop a little bit this, and let's continue with the same in Spanish.